Our mission is to increase the number of students from underrepresented groups in the transportation graduate programs, both at our UNL and as well as our partner institutions. Our end goal is obviously not to have any students from underrepresented groups, that everyone's fully engaged in the transportation programs.
The focus has been more strategic and focused in terms of why you should go on to grad school and the strategies to be successful when you are in grad school.
By investing in yourself or looking or at least considering the opportunity to contribute, you may be, you will help yourself.
This conference actually brings students from all over the United States. We have students from Maryland, from Tennessee, from Texas, from Louisiana, everywhere. So I think because we are combining them from different states, that spread the word of the importance of graduate school. So I think that's good for us.
Not all students know how to get to grad school or what it takes to go to graduate school, you know, who to talk to and what the questions are, how do you pay for it. So it allows us to provide that information to students that may not ordinarily get it.
We can bring opportunity to them. We can bring options to them. We can show them how the road opens rather than closing.
My favorite part in a way is like interacting with everybody else to just see how, to see which different paths of which they're taking.
It was a joint effort from Judy Perkins from Prairie View A&M University, one of our partners, Stephanie Adams, who's now at Virginia Tech, and myself. We sat down and thought, how can we have the most impact? And we have a problem. What can we do to help solve that problem? Later on, Dr. Eric Jones from University of Texas, Arlington, also joined the group.
We didn't really see where there was a program that existed that would target the minority kids from the perspective of African Americans, Hispanics, Native Americans, women, and do it in a very specialized way and a very personable way. So that's something, a touch that we have that possibly other programs don't have.
In particular, the Scholars Program, what makes it unique is the way they kind of keep it personal as far as, you know, the professors and the people and the speakers and all those that they bring. It's always, hey, I'm available, come talk to me.
It introduced students to a whole new thought process about what am I going to do with the rest of my life.
They have such a caring, you know, staff and so many people who really want to see young people succeed, and I think that really distinguishes them.
We're actually filling a gap that I've seen over the years in terms of the preparation and exposure to all the graduate opportunities that are available to minority students.
You're not only bringing minority students to a majority environment, you're opening up their mind to dispel all the idiosyncrasies they might have about themselves, but also at the same time, making them to be open-minded to look at environments they would not have thought about.
For some, I don't think they ever thought that they could even go to graduate school. And so to listen to them now from the first day and where they're at today, and that was just yesterday, it's amazing to see the transformation and the transition these students are experiencing just in the little short time they've been here.
The part, say the most important part I learned was the possibilities that can be attained by getting higher education, and also it actually gave me a renewed sense of, you know, belief that I could actually attain a PhD.
To really get knowledge on what graduate school is, like, first I wasn't excited, but now I know I'm going.
I see it now. I see the pay it forward. I see the passion that I have shown in some of those students.
It's an opportunity to network. It's a chance to hear success stories, to see what you can really do with a PhD. And why, as a minority, and especially as a minority female, it's important to pursue that and to keep going after that.
I think that we are creating the next generation of leaders. And whatever we can do to provide them with the skills and knowledge that they need is only a benefit to the nation.
You look around and these seeds are starting to sprout, and you realize that true commitment gets planted, and then when it gets planted, then it starts coming up in all different places. And when that happens, you start realizing the world is going to be a better place.
And one of the things that I want the students to take from this experience is, you know, opportunity will knock, but then pick a lock. And so I'm going to have to get quiet within myself and decide, how do I make success happen for me? This is what these 2 days is all about.